Today I'm going to be cleaning this home and I will be using the Challenger OP and the Workhorse vacuum. Now first I'm going to split the video up into basically two videos. The first one here is going to be just the pre-vacuuming, and then I'll follow up and upload the cleaning video later, because each one is close to half an hour long. So that would be just too much for one video. And I'll talk a little more about this particular home in the cleaning video, but I cleaned it about a year and a half ago with steam, and the carpets came out pretty good except for a couple areas like by that door where there's some issues. But I've had the Workhorse vacuum for a little while now, and I've used it on both residential and commercial jobs, and I'm pretty impressed with it so far. Now these two bedrooms are really not that bad. The hallway's a little soiled, but mainly this living room is the worst part of the house, and I thought this would be a really good place to do a video on the Workhorse to show you just how much soil that it can pull out. So far the only drawback that I've really found from the Workhorse vacuums is they don't edge very well, so you have to use the onboard hose to do some edging, which you'll see later in the video. Now I still love my Sanitaire vacuums. They do a little better job, actually do a good bit better job on edging. All right, let's see how much soil the Workhorse pulled out. I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed with it. And I expected it to do pretty good, especially on this carpet and knowing how much traffic this has had through here. But, you know, if you look at all that fine soil that it pulls out that I don't think a lot of other vacuum cleaners are able to get out, you know, the Workhorse works really good. So I'm going to go ahead and get this canister emptied and we'll get started on the haul. just looking at the carpets, I wouldn't have thought the vacuum would have been able to get that much soil out of them.